Hello, my name is Blake Sanchez, and I'd like to just quickly give you a bit about myself. I'm a mix engineer, a recordist, a songwriter, and a sound designer, and as well, a student at Full Sail University. So in this podcast, I want to talk a little bit about Peter Frampton, one of the most iconic guitar players and influential musicians of his time. In the spring of 1976, Peter released what would eventually become the best-selling album in history, Frampton Comes Alive. None of Peter's previous studio-recorded albums even came close to this LP, which sold more than 6 million copies within the first year. Some of the more recognizable titles off the album include Show Me the Way, Baby I Love Your Way, and Do You Feel Like We Do, which is my personal favorite. Peter essentially opened a new market for labels, and that was live albums. After the success of this album, they would do this many times again because it was inexpensive and highly profitable. His performance was truly magical, and what stood him apart from many others was his use of the talk box, which can be related to the common day vocoder. He used it in sync with his guitar and would actually mouth out words while playing the guitar. It was quite amazing to watch. I can still remember when my dad first let me hear Peter Frampton and his talk box, and I was blown away. Let me play the segment that my dad played for me. Frampton was influential in the usage of longer songs, like the one currently playing, just over 14 minutes. It was edited down to 7 for the radio, but was still one of the longest songs to ever reach the top 40. I believe that the Frampton phenomenon and this album should truly be studied due to the impact that he had. I mean, everything from artists wanting to have concerts moving to stadiums, like this one, and even large multinational corporations getting invested into the music industry. As an industry professional, I listened to this album and I'm truly inspired. Peter did something never done before and created a whole new market for the music industry. So in the next 5 years, I plan to work in a studio and try to come up with something as unique as he did. I remember him talking about how the standing ovation made him forget that they were even recording at the concert in Winter Garden. This is why his performance was so great, and why I'll remember, as I work my way up the ladder, that the performance is what's key, and trying something new is never a bad thing.